When we talk about the greatest entrepreneurs of all time, the name of Elon Musk shines right through as someone who has made a massive impact on several industries. He is changing the way we travel with Tesla. He is taking humans to space with his company SpaceX to make sure that humans finally become a multi-planetary species. He is digging tunnels with the Boring Company to change the layout of entire cities. And he is building the Hyperloop to reduce travel time dramatically. All of these projects are quite impressive, but none comes close to this one project that aims to change everything about humans. Yes, we are talking about Neuralink. While it aims to resolve various brain-related health issues in the beginning, the company is keen on creating human cyborgs in the long run and give humans some of the most incredible powers that one can imagine. In the short term, Neuralink may only be used for reducing suffering by getting rid of various brain-related disorders and diseases. However, in the long run, Neuralink promises to turn humans into cyborgs. So what exactly is Neuralink, and why is it so important? Well, Neuralink is a neurotechnology company that Elon Musk founded with the purpose of developing implantable brain-machine interfaces. The company was founded in 2016 and has its headquarters in San Francisco. It employs some of the most brilliant scientists, doctors, electrical engineers, and surgeons working to produce a brain chip that would attach to the human brain. The aim is to improve the performance of the human brain, eliminate various brain-related diseases, including paraplegia, blindness, and mental health conditions like depression, anxiety, and addiction. But this will just be the beginning. Such a technology will ultimately lead to humans being able to control devices with their thinking, gaining super intelligence, superhuman vision, and it may even give the ability to download your entire brain onto a computer, which later you can upload onto a new body or even a robot. This may sound like science fiction, but it now seems totally possible, and Neuralink plans to make it a reality. Now the question is, how does Neuralink work? How will the connection between the human brain and the computer chip be established? Well, to really understand how Neuralink will work, we have to understand the human brain first, and then take a look at how Neuralink's brain chip will establish its connection. So basically, our brain consists of billions of neurons that send and receive information in the form of electrical signals. These signals are sent out to our body whenever we move, hear, talk, or even blink. The Neuralink chip will connect directly to the brain through tiny microscopic threads that are about 1/20th the width of a human hair. They connect with the neurons in the brain to send and receive electrical signals. Now, one of the most critical things in the success of Neuralink is going to be how easy or difficult it is to actually get this chip into a brain. If it involves a very complicated invasive surgery, then obviously people won't really be inclined towards it. But, according to Elon Musk, the latest Neuralink chip, which is known as Link V0.9, can be installed onto a human being by surgery within an hour. Also, the person will be able to leave the hospital on the same day. The company plans to use precision robots to remove a coin-sized piece of skull and then carefully insert the chip. The robots will first image the brain and make sure that they avoid any veins or arteries so that the electrodes can be inserted with no noticeable damage. The brain-machine interface, or BMI device, used by Neuralink will work with a battery, which will be able to last a full day. There will be a need to recharge the battery, which according to Elon Musk, could be achieved by wearing a special nightcap. According to Elon Musk, the latest Neuralink chip is actually like a Fitbit, with tiny wires, except instead of wearing it on your wrist, it fits in the skull. During his presentation in August 2020, Elon Musk showed a Neuralink demo. It seemed like a scene from a science fiction movie. During the demo, Elon Musk and his Neuralink team showcased three live pigs. One pig did not have a brain implant. The second pig had a link implanted and then had it removed without any issues. And the third pig, named Gertrude, had a chip inside his brain for 2 months. He behaved just like other pigs. The amazing thing was that we could see a live reading of the neurons in the pig's brain, firing electrical signals in real time. These signals were indicated by beeps. The chip was also able to predict the pig's movement based on its brain activity. It was truly a remarkable demonstration that removed many doubts from people's minds and brought some credibility to the work Elon and his team at Neuralink are doing around this very sensitive and controversial subject. However, to think that a single demo would remove all the doubts in people's minds and would pave the way for human trials would not be correct. There are many factors that will come into consideration from the relevant authorities before permission is granted for human trials. The first issue is obviously that of safety. There needs to be significant evidence that the Neuralink brain-machine interface is safe for humans and that it won't cause any immediate or long-term adverse effects. The second issue is that of morality and ethics. There may be a huge debate that it is unethical to hack into the human brain, which the scientists at Neuralink are trying to do. Some may argue that they are trying to play God, while others may be of the opinion that it is just the natural progression of the scientific research and development in the field. Regardless of the outcome, the debate will ensue, and there will be a lot of heated arguments both for and against Neuralink. One of the most important moral questions is that of privacy. Let's say that Neuralink is granted permission to conduct human trials at a mass level, and these trials go well. How will Neuralink ensure that their thoughts, behaviors, and all the data collected from the subjects' brains will be safe? Who will have access to that data? And what if someone tries to hack the brain-machine interface chip? All these are valid questions that need to be answered before Neuralink can start human trials. Now the question is, how far Neuralink actually is from being able to successfully demonstrate this technology on humans? Well, if we are talking about the chips that will be able to solve various health conditions, then they are probably not far away, considering the fact that Elon Musk really puts in the effort to deliver what he promises. We'd have to say it would be around 2025, or probably sooner. This will probably be followed by us being able to control gadgets with our thinking. And then eventually we'll get to that insane stuff, such as being able to download our brain, or maybe supplement it with artificial intelligence and stuff like that. All that crazy stuff is probably still decades away, but we are surely moving in that direction. One of the motivations of Elon Musk behind creating Neuralink is to increase the bandwidth of human communication. According to Elon Musk, today, human beings are already cyborgs. Our cell phones, computers, and other devices are already sort of extensions of our body. They allow us to communicate with other people at a massive scale. The major hurdle that we have while communicating with others is that of bandwidth. There is not a lot of information that we can put out by using our tongue or by typing with our fingers. Having the brain-machine interface will solve this problem. We will be able to communicate on the internet just with our thinking. The communication will be so rapid that it is probably too hard to comprehend for humans today. However, once that happens, everything will change. There will be an explosion of information and ideas all around the world. Innovation will be at an all-time high. At even advanced level, Neuralink will try to sync up the human brain with artificial intelligence and create a symbiotic relationship. The intelligence of such humans having a symbiotic relationship with artificial intelligence will probably be millions of times higher than that of the smartest humans that live today. It is also worth mentioning that on a number of occasions, Elon Musk has shown his concerns that artificial intelligence is the greatest existential threat faced by humans. According to him, artificial intelligence can become so powerful in the near future that it would be able to outsmart human beings. It can become more powerful and possibly destroy humanity. In such a scenario, using Neuralink to establish a connection between the human brain and artificial intelligence can prove to be of critical importance. For now, Neuralink is still in its early stages, and there is a long way to go. But it will be interesting to see how things pan out in the future. What do you think about Neuralink and its impact on the world? Would you get a Neuralink chip installed in your brain? Let us know by leaving a comment down below. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell icon to stay updated whenever we release a new video. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.